Dr. Kavan Ratnatunga. I'm an astrophysicist by profession. I retired back to Sri Lanka in 2005. And over the last 13 years, I've been involved with developing a collection on coins and currency of Sri Lanka. Somewhere around 1993, I went to a coin show in Baltimore, just out of interest. There was this seller from Sphinx who was offering gold coins from Sri Lanka, 11th century gold coins from Sri Lanka. And it was the first time that I realized that I could buy one of these and own an 11th century gold coin from Sri Lanka. Somewhere around 1997, the origins of eBay, before eBay became even eBay, they were called Auction Web or something. I became a member and I started finding all this Sri Lankan stuff that was Ceylon stuff that were being sold there, no one was interested in. And for about 3 years, I had a free hand on everything that was auctioned of value on Ceylon coins on eBay. There are certain collectors who actually sold their collections to me because they wouldn't sell it to anybody else, because with me they know that I'm not going to sell it, that I would catalog it on the internet and that it would last for a long time. So it was around that time that, around 1998 or so, I mean after the web got in, I sort of realized there was very little information on Sri Lanka on the web. And what I wanted to do was to add some sort of information on Sri Lanka, which would be attract. You can't just put tourist information, people don't think. So my choice was to do some website on stamps, on coins on Sri Lanka. I started with stamps actually, and then I soon realized that stamps have only 150 years of history, and whereas coins have 2,300 years of history. So I forgot about the stamps and concentrated on coins. But I have a problem of wondering how I can protect this beyond my lifetime to get this collection into a safe place where it would be safe. And unfortunately, the places in Sri Lanka are not considered all that safe. There is not really a place where you can trust both the integrity to make sure that this collection will remain safe, as well as the competence to handle the collection in a way that it will not be damaged. And unfortunately, the latter is more real in Sri Lanka.